Good day, students, and welcome to today's episode of Math. Today's episode will be on Engage New York Mathematics, Grade 4, Unit Number 1, and Lesson Number 7. This was built for fourth graders just like you. So, let's go ahead and first review our learning targets. That's what we will be learning today, and let's make sure we're on the mark. This is what you're going to go home and tell mom and dad that you learned today. So, let's go ahead and read what they say. It says, I will be able to round multi-digit numbers to the thousands place using a number line. Ooh, so let's go ahead and break that down step by step. So what we're able to do is round. What are we going to round? Multi-digit numbers. Numbers with multiple digits. And we're going to round them to the nearest thousands place. So we're going to round multi-digit numbers to the thousands place. And we are going to use a number line. All right. So remember, that's what we're going to learn today. So the first thing we need to do is talk about rounding. Rounding is useful in math because it helps us become more familiar with numbers and being able to do things like estimate in our heads. So what is rounding? Rounding is finding the closest number. Rounding about is about finding the closest number. For example, let's say that we had two quarters in our pocket and we had 50 cents. And I wanted to know, is 50 cents closer to zero or is it closer to a dollar? Well, 50 cents is in the middle. And I don't want to say that I have 0 cents. It seems to me that 50 cents would actually be closer to a dollar because it is half or more. If I had just one quarter, that would be 25 cents to say, and sadly, that would be closer to 0 cents. Luckily, I don't have just 25 cents. I have 50 cents, and it's closer to a dollar. Remember, when it's halfway or greater, we round up. When it's halfway or less, less than halfway, the number usually stays the same. All right, so let's go ahead and do an example problem. Let's look at and see what it says up here. This problem says, is 4,100 closer to 4,000 or is it closer to 5,000? Well, we need to see which number this is closer to. So let's go ahead and take a look. First, I'm going to draw a number line. I'm going to label my 2 points. So I have 4,000, which would be to the bottom of the number line, and I have 5,000, which would be the top. So remember that halfway point is going to tell me, do I need to round up? Or is my number going to more or less stay the same? So let me see here. So the halfway point would be 4,500. That makes sense because if I got rid of these zeros, and I got rid of these zeros, and I got rid of these zeros, and I just looked at the numbers like that, it seems to me that that's like, let's get rid of this now, make it even a little clearer. 45 is halfway between 40 and 50. Therefore, if we take the numbers back the way they were, 4,500 is halfway between 4,000 and 5,000. Great. So we need to go back and we need to say, hey, is 4,100, is it closer to 4,000 or is it closer to 5,000? Well, it's below the halfway mark right here. So it seems to me that 4,100 is closer to 4,000. So we just rounded 4,100 down to 4,000. It is closer to 4,000. That's a little bit of a preview of what we are going to be learning today. Quickly, one more time, let's go ahead and review our learning targets. So our learning targets is what we're going to be learning today. We will be able to round multi-digit numbers. We're going to round multi-digit numbers to the thousands place using a number line. So that's our first example. Let's go ahead and continue. All right, put your listening ears on and let's go.